Good morning friends, this is Bhaskar Paul from JapaneseShiksha.com. Today we are going to learn about 10 things which are forbidden or never to do in Japan. First and most important thing is never use the title san with your name or your family name. Okay, so many of us probably do not know what the actual meaning of san is and how it has to be used, and we keep on using it with every other name, every other person's name who come along in our journey. So basically the san is, if you translate it or if you relate it with Hindi or English, it's like G that we used with every name, like Rahul G or something like that. And as compared to that, in English it would be like Mr. Rahul or Mr. Michael or some of that sort. So san is always has to be used for the opposite person, the person in front of you and your other members of the team, not for yourself. So san, never use san for your name. So you can't say that it's I am Bhaskar Paul san. So that's the basic rule for using san. Kindly remember that. The second thing is that you always, when you are addressing your superiors, your bosses, your teachers, you generally do not call them with their first name or like the you kind of thing. And direct pointing of the person with his name or something like or you is not being considered very well in Japan, and that's not something that that's commonly used. So generally they would use the family name and san, with san or sama, and sama is much more honorific than san. And to special professions like teachers, they are called as sensei. The shacho is basically the boss of the company. So that way they have categorized these kind of honorific terms, and they use it according to their position. The third point is they are very particular about that they don't prefer, or not even prefer, they don't, it's kind of very, it's a very stringent protocol, I would say, where they won't allow, or we should not be entering into someone's house, even in our own house, with our shoes on. So basically they have a system like tatami, which is like carpet, which is made of straw. So if we walk on the tatami with straws, what happens is that it will get damaged over the period of time, and even the damaging concept, even the cleanliness perspective and hygiene perspective also, it's not something which is done in Japan. So always keep your shoes outside the house, and you have, also there is a way to keep it, we'll cover that in the subsequent slides, that they keep the shoes in a way that when you are coming out of the house you can wear it directly, and it's always put very nicely, and it just should not look bad. Fourth point that we are going to cover is that whenever you are being offered with some food, or you are sitting in a restaurant and the food comes, you are sitting with your colleagues. So before starting the food, we always call, we say that itadakimasu. It's pronounced as itadakimasu. Now it means that I gracefully receive it, and it's paying a tribute to the maker of the food or who has offered you that food. And then at the end of the meal, when you have finished the meal, it's called gochiso samadeshita. Another thing is that what does gochiso samadeshita or gochiso sama means is that I thank you for the meal that you have prepared. Again, if you say they are very much taking care of the other person's efforts that they have put at. Point number five is never blow your nose in a public or a conference or meeting, which is definitely we don't do a lot of times, but still it has to be taken care in with some special care in Japan. And even they do not use handkerchief also. So people do keep a tissues or tissue papers, which is actually you get it very 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 commonly in Japan. So a lot of people do. This is a marketing stuff, so along with the marketing small pamphlet, they provide this tissue paper also, which you can keep in your pocket if you have cold. And use that always for blowing the nose. Point number six is about gift wrapping. So whenever you are given with some gift, which could be some biscuits or some kind of to eat, or a decorative piece, which could any sort of gift, it will be always, first of all, Japanese people will always pack it very nicely. Will not be like packed untidily. And then as a receiver of the gift, of course, after saying thanks and everything, when you are opening the gift or the wrapper of the gift, do not be in a hurry and just tear it out like we all, not all, but at many points we do. We are very much excited to open it and see what is inside. So that's not something that should be done in Japan. And they are again putting a very good value or a respect to the person who has packed it nicely. So they would open this paper very calmly, fold it back, and it's not for the purpose of reusing it. That might not be depending on the condition of that paper, but don't tear it apart. So that's the bottom line. Moving on, the point number seven is you do not keep the chopsticks inside the rice bowl, like digging into it. No, that's not something that has to be done in Japan. And generally, Japanese people do carry their own chopsticks, which it's basically safe from the hygiene perspective also. And the restaurants, they do offer disposable chopsticks made of wood or some material. So that's also a good practice to follow. Point number eight is regarding using the ofuro, the bathtub. A bathtub is something which is common for the complete family or the group. So the basic work of washing soap, putting soap and rinsing your body is done outside into a shower. And then when you are entering into the ofuro or the bathtub, you're basically cleaned, and it's basically for a soaking and relaxation purpose. So whatever we have seen in our movies, where you put a lot of foam and then you're rinsing and your body, so that's not what Japanese people do. So they do it outside and then you use the water. There is a scarcity of natural resources in Japan, so they have adopted these kind of good habits in every aspect of their life. Okay, point number nine is they are very much basically a reserved kind of person. So they don't prefer to kiss, hug or embrace too fondly in the public. And as we all know that they bow when they meet new people, and not even new people, when they bow when they meet. And basically, if a woman or man also is not giving their hands for handshaking, it's not a good practice to go ahead and you deliberately trying to do it. And don't get offended also if they are not receptive of this, because that's not their culture. Point number 10 is something like they accept this compliments, and even if it is genuine one, with a very humble way. And they always deny, or it's not about they, we, and when we are in Japan, we should follow the similar culture so that they don't feel bad or awkward about it. So whenever you are getting a comment, so when probably you know a bit of Japanese and then somebody says that, yeah, you are doing good, yes, you speak very good Japanese, although you probably are not, but they will say that to encourage you. And because they're definitely like somebody coming from an outside country and learning their language, and especially a new one who's trying to understand, they really appreciate that. Now, when they're saying it, so don't take it as a compliment, yeah, I'm very good. I always say like, Tondemorimasu, and of course not, Mada narou koto ga arimasu. All these things we can be said. Or Mata jozo ni narou koto ga dekimasu. So, but then there is a lot of scope of improvement. Point number 11 is that they are very cultured and very modest. If you can think through what I said in the last 10 points, you can make out that they are very humble, modest, and very civilized, actually. And so they want the opposite party also to follow the same and learn all these things. So never do anything which is drawing attention in the public, or your actions are trying to gather some attention. And so they do not do these kind of things in Japan or in Japanese culture. They don't like it, or that's not something that they are used to. So that's all I wanted to cover, I think, in these slides. If you have not subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe to our channel, and we'll be keep bringing up with more such contents which are interesting, and probably a series of how a Japanese how the Japanese language can be learned, basically from N5 level, a basics of Japanese, where we'll be teaching you more of vocabulary, sentence patterns, and a lot of aspects from the Japanese language. It will take us a bit of time, but definitely we'll come up with a very good lecture series on the same. Thank you. See you until next time. Bye bye.